and a hearty Scottish welcome to the podcast. This is Simply Scottish, and I'm your host, Andrew McDermott. Today, we're celebrating the 263rd birthday of Mr. Robert Burns, the National Bard of Scotland. Going beyond the typical profile of the man, I'll share with you how Burns became a household name in America throughout the 19th century, and his role in helping to unify the United States during the Civil War. You'll hear a few poems written about the bard, and learn why we need Burns today, perhaps more than ever before. First, let's continue listening to this catchy tune. It's Hamish Napier with Whirlpool. A few shout-outs to begin the show. I heard again from my kilt maker friend Patricia in Vermont. She listened to the Scottish Merchant Navy Radio Archive episode that we put out recently and thought it was enduring to intertwine my voice with my dad's voice from 20 years ago when we did Simply Scottish as a radio show. I'm actually getting excited at the possibility to own my own custom-made kilt. I think I'd be the first in my family line to do that. I had to rent a kilt for my wedding some years back. It's high time I had a quality handmade kilt in the McDermott tartan. So looking forward to having your help with that, Patricia. I also heard recently from a new listener in Calgary, Canada. Norman is glad to find Simply Scottish to feed his passion for his Scottish heritage. He's planning a trip to Scotland in 2023. Norman, I'm excited for you to get to Scotland. You're going to love it. I hope to bring my children back to my homeland soon as well. My wife has experienced it, but not my kids yet. Thanks again for listening, Norman. Well, I was surprised when I checked in on my podcast statistics recently. If the numbers are accurate, around as many people are listening to the show via a smartwatch as through a computer or smartphone combined. I find that a bit hard to believe. Is it true? Could it be true in this day and age? If you listen via smartwatch, let me know. I'd like to get a feel for this. I also noticed the map of countries where people were tuning in. The top five countries for listenership are the US, the countries of the UK, Australia, Canada, and Germany. And then there's smaller numbers of listeners in dozens of other countries, including the United Arab Emirates, Italy, Ghana, Bermuda, Brazil, the Czech Republic, Spain, India, and even a few brave souls in North Korea. Wow. Well, now it's your turn to get in touch with me and tell me where in the world you're listening from and what you love about Scotland. Email me at andrew@simplyscottish.com. That's andrew@simplyscottish.com. As long-time listeners will know, I write poetry as well as non-fiction articles and other things like podcasts. And so I thought I'd kick off today's celebration of Robert Burns with a poem I wrote inspired by him. On a visit to Stanley Park, a large public reserve on the water's edge in Vancouver, British Columbia, I was pleased to discover a statue of Robert Burns. I sat at the foot of the statue and penned this poem, an attempt to capture the spirit of equality and fraternity woven into Burns's own work. Lines written below a statue of Robert Burns in Stanley Park, Vancouver. Once again, he reminds me that we are all children in the same family. It's the sentiment of Lord Stanley, too, standing nearby with open arms to people of all colors, creeds, and customs. These statues set the tone for the steady stream of visitors who enter by horse and horsepower, bicycle and foot. It's the reason the mother watching her children play will look over at you and smile. Why the vendor will take extra care packing your ice cream. Why the beluga whale will seem to slow as it swims by in the tank, giving you time to take in its prominent forehead and dark, piercing eyes. It may also be why you pick up the stray wrapper on the forest path, and why you offer to take a picture for the newlyweds at Hallelujah Point. And it's quite possible, however unlikely, that the squirrel sitting on the rock while you eat your lunch will give you a nod, remembering a poem he read once about a helpless field mouse and the kind young man who noticed it and saved it from the blade of his plough. The first collection of poems Burns published is known as the Kilmarnock Edition, printed in the summer of 1786. Kilmarnock Edition is also the name of a lively Scottish folk band, so I looked them up and thought I'd include a song from them here. This song happens to fit right in with Burns' suggestion to tack a couple kindness yet. It's called Pay It Forward.
You've gone mad and the world goes bare, people pulling out their hair. It's a sorry state of affairs, and they say nobody gives a monkey's. But behind the big headlines, down the street you'll always find people willing to be kind with a little bit of pay it forward. If they're hungry, give it half, run your beloved a big bubble bath. Even making someone laugh with a little bit of pay it forward.
Suck away in Milton Keynes. Help to boost
listening to Simply Scottish. On this episode, I want to show you why we need Robert Burns in 2022. Before I get to the present, though, I want to share a few things from the past. It's interesting to note that Burns' popularity in the United States quite possibly eclipsed even Scotland itself. At the turn of the 19th century, a young America did not have much of a literary tradition of its own yet. Some of the country's first leaders were Burns fans, including George Washington. By 1820, Burns clubs were springing up around the US. His songs were parodied in presidential elections, evidence of how much the general population knew his work. His verses were used in the Texas Revolution and sung by both Union and Confederate armies during the Civil War. One man in particular would be deeply impacted by Burns. Long before the Battle of Fort Sumter ignited the Civil War in 1861, a teenage Abraham Lincoln discovered Scotland's bard. Along with Holy Scripture and Shakespeare, Lincoln quickly committed to memory some of Burns's most popular poems and songs, including Tam O'Shanter, The Twa Dugs, and Scots Wha He. Here was a man from similar humble beginnings who not only shared a strong faith in God's providence, but also conviction in the intrinsic worth of the ordinary individual. As Ferenc Morton Saz points out in his book Abraham Lincoln and Robert Burns, Connected Lives and Legends, Lincoln found in Burns a kindred spirit he would carry with him throughout his whole life. And it would not be unreasonable, I think, to say that Burns' lyrics about the equality of man reinforced the belief in Lincoln's heart that all men are created equal. "The rank is but the guinea's stamp," says Burns. "The man's the gowd, the gold, for all that." 4 years after the end of the Civil War, many Americans came together, joining with people in other countries, to celebrate the 100th anniversary of Burns's birth. At least 61 cities in America held gatherings toasting the immortal memory of Rabbi. American President James Buchanan noted that Burns is read everywhere and by all classes throughout the extent of our country. It was said at the time that Burns's words perfectly described American ideals, and that in turn these ideals were truly universal. One cleric put it this way: "A man's a man for all that is the Declaration of Independence set to music." Several American writers and poets of the time paid tribute to Robert Burns in verse. One of them was John Whittier. In his poem, On Receiving a Sprig of Heather and Blossom, he writes, "O'er rank and pomp, as he had seen, I saw the man uprising, no longer common or unclean, the child of God's baptizing. With clearer eyes I saw the worth of life among the lowly. The Bible at his cotter's hearth had made my own more holy." He also put Burns's sinful failings into perspective, offering this advice: "Let those who never erred forget his worth in vain bewailings. Sweet soul of song, I own my debt, uncancelled by his failings." And later, "But think, while falls that shade between the erring one and heaven, that he who loved like Magdalene, like her may be forgiven." Lately, I've been wondering, if Burns could be so instrumental in reminding Americans in their fledgling republic of the value of their freedoms and democracy, couldn't he do it again in 2022? We'll consider that next. First, back to music. In 1786, Burns was facing financial difficulties and hardship, as well as an increasingly complicated personal life. He was offered a job as a bookkeeper on a slave plantation in Portland, Jamaica. Burns booked his ticket to Jamaica and made plans to leave Scotland. One wonders how such a move would have affected him, given his strong support for the value of his fellow man. And if he had taken the trip, we might never have gotten the poems and songs we now cherish today from Burns. So it's just as well that someone suggested he publish a book of poems to raise money for the trip. That first collection sold splendidly, "rousing my poetic ambition," Burns himself put it in a letter to a friend. Around the same time, he discovered he had become the father to twins, Jean and Robert, with Jean Armour. Burns never got on that ship to Jamaica, but he did write a poem called The Slave's Lament, which was published in 1792. The song was written from the perspective of a Senegalese woman captured in Africa and taken to Virginia. Here's Jamaican singer Brina with an evocative arrangement of that Burns song from the album Jamaica Sings Robert Burns.
Senegal, that my foes did me enthrall, for the Isle of Jamaica, oh, torn from that lovely shore, and must ne'er see no more. Oh, alas, I am weary, weary, oh, torn from that lovely shore. Oh, must never see no more. Oh, alas, I am weary, weary, oh. All on that charming coast was no brutal whipping post like the Isle of Jamaica, oh, oh, where streams forever flow grow. Oh, alas, I am weary, weary, oh. There streams forever flow, and children ever grow. Oh, alas, I am weary, weary, oh. The burden I must bear, while the cruel scourge I fear, on the Isle of Jamaica, oh. And I think of family dear with a sorry, bitter tear. Oh, alas, I am weary, weary, oh. And I think of family gone with a sorry, bitter scorn. Oh, alas, I am weary, oh.
As you're well aware, humanity is facing a lot of issues right now. There's the COVID-19 pandemic, the division over race relations, the scourge of wokeness pervading our institutions, inflation, nuclear threats, unstable regimes, natural disasters, to name just a few. Robert Burns, I think, can help all of us get through these difficulties and avoid the potential of greater conflict and maybe even another civil war. His advice is threefold. First, he'd have us rise above cancel culture. Burns penned bold ideas, and for that, he had his haters. If he had kept his mouth shut like his superiors in the Scottish Board of Excise wanted him to, he would have gotten promoted. Life might have been better, at least financially. But he couldn't, and thankfully he pushed aside harsh criticism and attempts to de-platform him, as they say today, by writing some of his best and bravest lines. We too can sideline today's intolerant cancel culture in the same way. Second, Burns would remind us who we really are underneath it all. Knowing your own value and that of others around you will help you be more gentle and gracious with people. And let he who made the heart do the judging, as Burns says in his poem, Address to the Unco Good. Finally, Burns can help us come together in 2022 and beyond by reminding us of the rare gifts of liberty and democracy. In Ode for General Washington's Birthday, he writes, But come, ye sons of liberty, Columbia's offspring, brave as free, in danger's hour still flaming in the van, ye know and dare maintain the royalty of man. He goes on to praise the arm that crushed usurpation's boldest daring and the despot's proudest bearing. I've written an article on why we need more Robert Burns today that goes into a bit more detail than I can here. You can find a link to it at simplyscottish.com. I'll also have it posted at the Simply Scottish Facebook page and Twitter feed. Well, that's about it for this episode. If you want to celebrate Burns some more, we do have a previous episode all about Burns, episode number 8, I believe, of the podcast. You can find it anywhere you get your podcasts. It'll be there. Our whole archive is up and online for you. And while you're on your favorite podcast platform, such as Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon, or Google Podcasts, give Simply Scottish a 5-star rating and write a review so others can more easily find the podcast. And don't forget, anytime you can send me a message, a suggestion, a comment, a song that you like or want to hear, or a topic for a future episode, you can reach me by email, andrew@simplyscottish.com. We'll close with music from The Complete Songs of Robert Burns, a fancy box set from Lynn Records in Scotland that contains over 360 songs. Quite an achievement. This one is a lovely rendition of My Love's Like a Red, Red Rose by Davy Steele. I've really enjoyed celebrating Rabbi with you today. Rabbi. Gotta roll those R's. I've gotten out of the habit living in America for so long, but it's in there somewhere. Thanks for celebrating Rabbi with me today. Among the thousands of podcasts out there you could be listening to, here we are together. Well, let's connect again soon for your next virtual trip to Scotland. Until then, happy Burns Day. I'm Andrew McDermott. Thanks for listening.
My love is like a red, red rose that's newly sprung in June. My love is like a melody that's sweetly played in June.
Simply Scottish is hosted and produced by Andrew McDermott. Show content, copyright, Simply Scottish Media. All music is used with consent of copyright holders. Continue your Simply Scottish experience at simplyscottish.com. Thanks for listening.
Till all the seas gone dry, till all the seas gone dry, my dear, and the rocks melt with the sun. I will love thee still, my dear, while the sun's whole life shall run. Thank you. And fare thee weel, my only love. Oh, fare thee weel a while, and I will come again, my love, though 10,000 miles. I will come again, my love, Lord, where 10,000 miles.